Tell some funny jokes, white boy. Hey, tell some funny jokes, Bill. What? Say, tell some funny jokes, white boy. I said, tell some funny jokes, Bill. Let's tap into it.
You know my squad. You know my squad. I said, now ain't nobody messing with my squad.
Subscribe squad, is another day, it's another dollar, it's time for another freaking reaction, because that is what we do. You look at me and I look at you, you look at me and I look at you, you look at me and I look at you. That is what we do. Now before we go ahead and react to some more Bill Burr, I need you to do me a favor. I need you to hit that like button, I need you to hit that sub button, I need you to hit that bell button, because you can ring my bell. Ring my bell, ring it, ring it, ring it. That we know every single time, literally every single time that I drop a new video. None of that, but Scribe Squad, we have this goal. We're trying to get to 20K subs by the end of the year. I know for a fact that we do, you know, I know we do it. I'm out here getting it. You're out here getting it. We'll go ahead, get it together and get to 20K subs. Not only that, but we only have 500 subs left to hit. 500 subs before we get to 20K subs by the end of the year. We have almost done it, Scribe Squad. Thank you guys so much for the support. I also have a new single out. It's called Let Him Go, new music video. If you click the link in the description below, thank you for the continuous support on this. It is called Let Him Go. Now with that being said, we love getting our laugh on, and so today we're going to continue on the Bill Burr rabbit hole, and we're going to react to a joke that he did on Conan. It is called He Got in Trouble for Making Fun of the Military. I'm interested to see how he got in trouble. He's always getting in trouble. Let's see what he has to say. Let's go ahead and tap into it.
No, this weekend, I understand.
Yes, I did.
Okay, how did it go?
It went great. It was just, you know, big show. Everything went great. And then one person, I was making fun of the military, you know, which you can't do now. Like, we totally went from Vietnam, all the hippies being like, hey, man, you're like a baby killer, man, to, like, now you got to give, like, a standing ovation when they walk over to Delta. You know what I mean? You know, show that you're not an ISIS. Like, I don't know what you have to be doing. Like, thank you. And so I do this bit making fun of the military a little bit. And the first time I did it at a VFW to make sure that it was funny in the right way. And it killed. It was even a dude, he lost his legs. He almost fell out of his chair, dying laughing, going, dude, that is so true.
So you got approval from
that.
Veterans.
So then
yeah.
I'm doing it in front of regular people, you know what I mean? So the second up, everybody has a good time with it except one person. He came all the way up to the front and just starts, didn't even heckle, just started yelling. He's like, hey, show some respect. He starts yelling at me like he's my dad, right? So he's like 100 pounds overweight. I'm like, why don't you show some respect and lose a little weight? Next time you have the middle seat on a flight, you won't be spilling over onto your fellow Americans. No, I know. I know that's off limits because now fat people are heroes. Everybody is a hero now.
Everyone's a hero.
No, I'm going to tell you what about fat people. Your organs are not giving you a standing ovation as you walk over to the refrigerator again. What you're doing is dangerous. You got children, lay off the ice cream. It's so brave. It's so brave to be out of that, you know, so whatever. So that guy, oh, my God. I was so upset that security, like, escorted him out. I wanted to talk. Like, I started my show blaming women for sexual harassment. That's how I started it. Yes, it was absurd. I wasn't being serious, you children. This is the worst time
I
ever.
I have to now move my chair away from you.
I know, because then all of a sudden, I know. Dude, it's literally...
It's tough times right now.
As a comedian, yeah, it's like the walls. It's like you're in this walk-in closet of what could be funny. And meanwhile, there's like a swirl of trash with every toothbrush he ever used spinning around the Pacific Ocean. Nobody cares. God forbid you tease the Navy a little bit and people have like a conniption.
Well, what did you say about the military that got people so mad? Or this one guy so mad?
I was just saying, like, yeah, the guy who flies the fighter jet, okay, and has missiles shot at him, that guy's a hero. However, if you're the guy that, like, points in the direction that the plane takes off in... You know what I mean? We're kind of watering down what is heroic behavior.
You don't think that guy, the guy who points in the direction is...
Yeah, the guy doing Warrior One, like the yoga pose. Like, the battlefield is that way. No, but everything has just become that. It's just become like this,
right.
This, you know, that whole first responder thing, you know, all these, like, code words you have to say. It's so stupid. I'm a first responder. I love that one. It's like, dude, I called you. I saw the fire. Like, what am I...
What do you have, like, ESP? We just want to thank our first responders, and just everything has just become, and it's, it drives me up the wall.
All right, we're gonna take a little break. We'll have more with Bill Burr. We'll calm him down during the commercial break.
Oh my goodness, Bill Burr is wild, though. I mean, but to a certain extent, he does have a point. Like, everybody's a hero now. Is everybody really a hero? Now, mind you, you know, like, people who really put their lives on the line, yes, you guys are heroes, but is everybody a hero? I definitely feel like a society definitely has a hero complex now. Everybody's a hero. They'll talk about anybody and everybody. I think to a certain extent, now mind you, I don't believe in shaming people or making people feel bad for what it is that who they are or whatever as a person. But at the same time, if you're heavily overweight, that's not something we should be worshiping. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's unhealthy. It's literally bad for your life. It's bad for your life. So it's like, I mean, how are you? And then the whole point of a joke is that it's a joke. And if it offends you, it's supposed to be offensive. It's supposed to offend somebody. It's a joke. I feel like, you know, we've kind of watered down too many things in our society. And sometimes you just got to learn how to laugh, bro. Just learn how to laugh. You don't have to agree with the person's thoughts or behaviors to think that something is funny. Something can just be funny. Some things are just funny. We're going to make jokes. We're going to bring jokes back in 2020. All right, let me know. More Bill Burr that we have yet to react to. Please let me know in the comments below. Watch another video on the channel. Hit the like button. Hit the sub button. But more importantly, have a good day. Thank you.